Bari, Sanj,
we have 34 people joined in.
Tukai Diu.
Tukai Diu, Father.
Tukai Diu, Father. Once again. Dev, Bari, Sanj, Diu.
Tukai Diu.
Tukai Diu.
Tukai Diu.
Tukai Diu, Father.
Good. There is a language called Hebrew. And Hebrew language and Konkani language, the history, there are some similarities. Hebrew was a dead language even at the time of Jesus. Nobody spoke Hebrew. It was only a written language that time. They spoke Aramaic there. But Hebrew was studied because that is the language of their scripture, Old Testament and other literature. This Hebrew language was revived by a person born, a Jew born in Russia. His name is Eliezer ben Yehuda. Eliezer ben Yehuda, born in 1858 in Russia. So he spoke Russian language. He studied Hebrew language. Then he went to Paris, where he learned French and German and all. And he realized he should revive Hebrew language. That will unite all the Jews. So in 1881, he came back to Palestine and settled down at Jerusalem. And what did he do? He started to speak Hebrew language with his wife and his children. Then few friends he joined, he convinced them, they too started to speak. Of course, it's a modern Hebrew. The old biblical Hebrew had only 8,000 words. So he coined new words, new phrases. There was opposition for him, a lot of opposition from the Jews. What is this nonsense? It is a dead language. We are speaking Yiddish, we are speaking Arabic and so many other languages. Why we need that? But he consistently worked. He prepared the dictionary. He was the first person to prepare the dictionary, Hebrew dictionary of modern Hebrew. And today, you know, Hebrew is the national language of Israel. They take pride in it. From KG to PG, every spheres of their life, they speak Hebrew. Now, my dream is that in Goa, why not we revive a standard Konkani, which unites everybody, a standard Konkani, based on old Konkani, accept good things from other dialects, accept words from other languages when we don't have, and have a standard Konkani. So this is my attempt in this line of this new writing system to help students like you who do not know Konkani at all or who know very little of it. So by this system, at least you will be able to read and pronounce Konkani correctly. I write this way only, whether on WhatsApp, anywhere. When I write, I use this system. What system you have to use, that is left to you. But, and I'm going to work on it, prepare the course. This is my ultimate now, a target. By end of this year, the material should be ready and it can be given to somebody to print. So let us say, I must thank you once again, because when I'm alone, I have no energy. Even if I want to work, I can't work. My head is so heavy, so sleepy, I have to lie down. But these days I'm working, my sleep has disappeared. I hardly sleep. I forget about meals time, everything. I was sharing with Savio, morning 8 o'clock, I'm here. 8 to 12:45. Then from 3 till night 11 o'clock, I work. I can go on still, but I say no, it is not good. The body needs rest. So I thank you for increasing my energy, and I hope I will get an assistant. I contacted a girl. She is ready. Let us see, by God's grace, if everything works, I should be able to do what Eliezer Ben Yehud did for Hebrew. I'll be able to do for Konkani. Okay. With this brief note, let me continue. Yesterday, we revised the vowel contrasts and we learned a number of greetings and common expressions. Any doubts? Only for 5 minutes, because at the end we will have question hours. Any doubts on yesterday, what you learned in the class?
Father?
Yes.
Yesterday someone was asking on the message what to say when we are taking leave in the afternoon. What do we say?
There is no afternoon. In Konkani, we don't say good afternoon. No, we don't have that.
Say, Father, but if I want to say now,
at what time? Afternoon means at what time?
1:30.
Yeah, then means you are meeting for the first time that person. Am I right?
Yes, Father.
Then you say, Diyobarodishtiyu.
And then when leaving, Father?
Beg pardon?
When we are leaving that person and going, like separating.
You are leaving at that person, you need not say, because at that time to say Deobari Radhyu makes not much sense.
There is nothing like for afternoon or good day. We say good
no,
day.
We don't have a good day. No, we don't have a Konkani equivalent for a good day. No.
Okay, fine.
We don't have.
Yes, thank you, Father.
Yeah. Yes. So let us continue then, if there are no questions. I take this once again.
Father, I had one.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
I had a question about the letter, V.
Yes.
Because when in Dev, D-E-V.
Yes.
Do you say Deo or do you say Dev?
Dev.
And also,
if it's one, for one God, we say Dev. Dev. We don't bite our lip.
Okay.
In English, you have to bite your lip when you say V.
Okay.
But this is like D-E-W, pronunciation, Dev. But if there are many gods, we say Dev. Like Chor, Chor, Pair, Pair, same way, Dev, Dev. Many.
Okay.
Yeah.
But in the good morning saying, does it become Deo? Like, does it become
not Dev, no, Dev. Dev. Dev.
It stays Dev only.
To Dev.
Okay. And what about H-A-N-V, which is I? How do you say that? Is H silent in that?
Au bitaryo, huh?
Which word is that?
Can I come in? Au bitaryo. Au bitaryo.
Visarlo.
So in that, au, in that.
Yes, au.
Can I come in?
Ah, may can I come in? Ah, how bitter you?
That's H is
so
silent.
So that how is that H is silent,
that
is
H
it?
Is not that prominent, but it is there in Old Konkani. I made sure it is there in Old Konkani. Throughout it is there, but it is not how. Slight aspiration is there.
Also in the end, the V is also not very pronounced. It's how.
Which one?
Is it? In the same word, H-A-N-V, how.
How? No, how is pronounced? How. How.
Okay.
How. It is not how. If you don't pronounce, it becomes how.
Right.
How.
Right. Okay. And last, Father, I wanted to know about the word goodbye.
Yes, we'll come to that. I'm coming to that. I'm coming now. As I read this, we are taking once again. You will come to that now. I start from here only. What you see now, Devarodishtiyu, Tumkaidiyu, Tukaidiyu, Devkurpadiyu. We have learned Devbari Sansdiyu, Tumkaidiyu, Tukaidiyu, Devbari Radhiyu, Tumkaidiyu, Tukaidiyu. देन देव बरें करूं तुम काय करूं तू काय करूं दिस वी हैव लर्न्ड ऑलरेडी
फादर वन लास्ट
यस
वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑन द प्रीवियस डे द वर्ड फॉर ड्राइड जिंजर
यस
एन प्रोनाउंस्ड और इज जस्ट अ नेजल ऊ
सूंट नो इट इज अ नेजल वॉवल
सो एन इज नॉट प्रोनाउंस्ड
N nasalizes that oo. It becomes oom, okay. Oom. Otherwise, it becomes, there is a difference between suit. Suit means discount and soont.
So you pronounce the N.
Soont. We don't pronounce N. We, that N nasalizes the previous vowel oo.
Okay, thank you. Yeah.
In a medial position, it is S-U-N-T-T. It is not soont. It is not sunt, it is sunt for us Catholics.
Okay, thank you.
But the Hindus would say differently. They will say sunt because they have lost the nasal vowel. They made it a nasal consonant. And we have retained the nasal vowels. From old Konkani, we have retained the sound. That is the characteristics of Konkani in Roman script.
Okay, thank
so
you.
So whatever we have good things, we should not give up. We can add good things from other dialects. There is no harm. So let us not be a close-minded people. It is Goa, Goa. No. Then we become, Goa becomes an island. We become islanders. No. Let us accept any good things, phrases, words, other. Let us accept, like English does. Any language, living language accepts. And that's what the modern Hebrew did. Today in modern Hebrew, they can express anything and everything. They have taken words from German. They have taken words from English. A lot of words in Hebrew are the words from English. They have accepted, but they have made their own. They have given their pronunciation. At times, they have given their meaning. So same process we should do for Konkani. Okay. Maaf karat, we have learnt. Excuse me. Chup zali, we have learnt. Upkar karun, we have learnt. Aam bitar yevu or aam bitar yevu, both are correct. Then besaundiyat and oh besaundi. Suppose you are dad, you don't want to use in plural, then you say besaundi. But to a respectable person, you better to use a plural, which I do. Except for small children, even students from 8th standard onwards, I use always plural. Even if there one person is there, boy or girl, I use plural. Besaun diyat, bless me. The answer would be devache besaun. Then, bare, o bare asa, okay. O bare, all right. O bare ter, okay then. Then how to say hello? See, in Konkani, common people have a nice phrase. O Bab, O Bai. Bab for a man and Bai for a lady. We have this phrase. O Bab, O Bai. Then, Veging Karat. Veging Karat. Hurry up. Ekdambare. See that M, there is an apostrophe because the M is a nasal consonant. It is other, without that apostrophe, it becomes ekdam, ekdam. No, it is ekdam. Here, bare. It is not barem. No, bare. Nasalizing the previous vowel, there is no apostrophe here. Ekdambare. Very nice. Good. VD/cigar, what up now? VD/cigar, what up now? No smoking. Vagepan sambalat. Vagepan sambalat, silence zone. That means maintain silence. Literally, it means maintain silence. Silence zone. Then, maka mazat karshat. And this word mazat now dialectically has become madat, but I have kept the standard form. which is found in Old Konkani and which is also used by people here in Goa. Maka mazat karshad, can you help me? Kitli varazali, what time is it? Or you can say, varangitli, same, what time is it? Or you can say, kitlo vel zalo, what time is it? So there are three ways of saying the same thing. Eksang, by the way, means, and there is something there. Eksang, tu khair autai, there is something else, therefore I put three dots. Eksang is not a complete sentence by itself, no. By the way, where do you reside? Then you say Eksang, for the by the way. Adeus, that we have learnt yesterday, goodbye, this is used by the Catholics. But adeus is only when that person is not going to meet for a very, very long time. Then only you say adeus, not short duration, you don't say adeus. Then, suppose you have visited a home and before you depart, what those people suppose they tell you? Vachuneya. See, this phrase is from a Hindu community, but we must accept it. It's a very nice phrase. Vachuneya. It means goodbye. And you must say Vachuneta. Even if they don't say Vachuneya, you must say Vachuneta. That means I go and I come back. You cannot say Veta. Veta, they will feel very hurt. Veta means as good as adeus. Vachun eyat, vachun etan is for goodbye. Another way of saying, bare etan, same meaning goodbye. So you can use either this or this or this, three, and this one for a long duration. You are not going to meet your friend or somebody, then you say adeus. This is, there is a song, Adeus Karcho Vel Paolo, a song. Why? Because in olden days, the bride, after her marriage, she would go to the bridegroom's place and she cannot come back here. It's only when they give permission, she can come to her own home, to her parents' home. Therefore, that song came, Adeus, and then she cries, everybody cries there. I mean, in olden days, nowadays, marriage is nobody cries. And no need also to cry, I think. Anyhow, they cry after the marriage. Bare, eta, goodbye. Voi, we have learned this. Yes. Nai, no, we have learned. Na, we have learned. Singular and nant for plural, not. This we have covered yesterday. Zai, we have learned yesterday. Zai means want. Naka, I don't want. This also we learned. Shabbas or wa, vareva, well done. Abba, with a surprise, you want, with a surprise you want to ask the question, what? Then Abba. Then Cheche, disapproval. What you mean to say? No. But just by saying Cheche, your disapproval is conveyed. Then expression of disgust, she or shishi. Then, here we were. Avais, avaige, arerere. This is an expression of surprise or pain or shock. Parbintumka, otuka, congratulations to you. Maje reka diat. Oh, maje reka di. See, always the plural form I put first. With respect, you say plural. And for a small children, you can say Parbintuka or Majareka di. Otherwise, you would say Majareka diya. Convey my greetings. Then, Maji Buzwan Tumka or Tuka, my condolences to you. Bare Magun, with best wishes. when you want to end a letter or note, you can write this way. Therefore, I put a comma, then you are going to sign there. Or there is another one, Mayemogan, with love or with affectionate or affectionately. You can use Mayemogan. Mogasum, with love. Baremakpi, well wisher. Yesterday, I think we stopped here. But I added many more words earlier. Therefore, I took it from the beginning. Then, Kalji Gayat or Gay, take care. Kalji Gayat or Gay. Kushal Rawat or Rao, remain cheerful. Asum, let it be. Puro, enough. Ye o eyat, come. Bus or basat, have a seat. This should have come first. I'll put it here because always I put plural first. Basat slash bus could be small, no problem, and no need of beer. Yes. Okay, basat, bus, have a seat. Then, barebashen karta, barebashen I karta, of course, I will, when English you say of course, then we conclude, we say barebashen. Paleta, I will see. Then you want to say definitely in English, how to say in Konkani? Sert. Sert ang Konkani shiktolo. Or dubawa viret. Dubawa viret. Oh, sorry here, mistake. Bilkul. Bilkul. Means definitely. And there are few more words for this definitely. Kainazo, doesn't matter. It cannot be Kani, remember in our system. K-A-K-A, K-A, in medial position, Ka, and this is here, Kainazo. Doesn't matter. Shituk, Rao. Rao should come here. Shituk Rao. Or Sambalun Rawat. You can say Shituk Rawat. Better to say Shituk Rawat. Shituk Rawat, Sambalun Rawat. Beware. Singular would be Shituk Rao, Sambalun Rao. Then, Chatrayen or Sadur Rawat, be careful. Chatrayen, Chatrayen. There are three syllables, there are three vowels. Therefore, Chatrayen, 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 Sadur, two syllables, Sadur, Rawat, Rawat. Chatrayen Sadur Rawat. Be careful. Bienakat. And for singular, Bienakai. Don't worry. Ogorao. If it's a man, you must say, or a boy, Ogorao. If it's a girl or a lady, you must say Ogi Rao. And Oge Rao, you can say for a small girl or your cat. Your cat is mewing and disturbing you. Then you speak Konkani, then the cat understands. I speak. I don't have animals here. When I was at Paruri Konkani Kendra, I was speaking Konkani to my dogs, to my cats, to my all the fowls, to the goats, to everybody. I was speaking Konkani and they understood. Ogorao, Ogirao, Ogerao. You. This is singular. Keep quiet. For information, you in English, modern English, it is plural. What is the singular of you in English? Old English. Thou. T-H-O-U. But now in the modern English, thou has gone. It has only remained in the prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, holy be thy name. See? So you is a singular. And you is also plural in English. That's why I put here. This Ogorao, when you want to give a command to a boy, to one person. But here you say Oge Rawat. The person may be just one, but you want to give him respect. Oge Rawat. If it's a lady or ladies, you say Ogyo Rawat. And there are children, make boys and girls. You say Ogi Rawat. You plural, keep quiet. Let me repeat. Ogarao. I'm telling to my dad, I'm not using, but dad, nobody uses plural among Catholics. So you say, Pai, tu ogarao. And to your mother, Mai, tu ogirao. And to your sister, small sister, you will say, tu ogarao. But this for respectable people, or there are more than one person, if there are men, you must say Oge Rawat. If there is a respectable lady, or there are many ladies, then you must say Ogyo Rawat. And there are children, mix, or there are men and women. Men and women, we use neuter plural. Tumi Ogi Rawat. You keep quiet. Then, Tumche, now kite, what is your name? But for a boy, I made a mistake here. But for a boy or girl, well, you can say Tuje naam kite. Tumche naam kite and Tuje naam kite. What is your name? Then the answer should be Mujhe naam and not Amche naam. Though you have been given respect, you must say, while answering, Mujhe naam, my name is so and so. Suppose you ask me a question, Tumche naam kite, I must answer, Mujhe naam Pratap Naik. I cannot say, Amche naam. And some priests here in Goa, with influence, I don't know what, they say, when I ask them, Father, tumche naam kite? They say, amche naam. No. It should be maje naam. Then, tumi khai rautat? Where do you reside? Tumi khai rautat? For a boy or girl, you can say, Tu khai rautai. Where do you reside? See here, Tu mi khai rautat. And Tu khai rautai. For this question, the answer, both this question, the answer is, Aam dash dash rauta. You say, where you? Aam UK rauta, Aam USA rauta, Aam Australia rauta, Aam New Zealand rauta, Aam Mumbai rauta. Whatever, I reside at dash dash dash. Suppose this question is asked for more than one person. Let us say there is a couple, and I ask them question, Tumi khai rautat? Then they supposed to say, Ami, Rao Tao. They have to put here the name of the place. Ami Delhi Rao Tao. Ami Kashmir Rao Tao. We reside at. Make this distinction. Tumi khai Rao Taat. Answer should be Aao. But if there are a couple, or let's say a brother and sister, and I am asking them question, Tumi khai Rao Taat. Or if there are two people, Tumi khai Rao Taat, I ask them, and both of them happen to be from the same place, then they would say Ami and not Aao. Ami Kolkata Rao Taat. Tumi kasha asat is a masculine. For masculine person, we ask like this. For a man, Tumi kasha asat, how are you? For a lady, you must ask, Tumi kasha asat, how are you? And for men and women or children, Tumi kasha asat, question mark should come here. How are you? Tumi kasha asat, tumi kasha asat, tumi kasha asat. But if it's a boy or girl, for a boy you will say tu kaso asai, and for a or your mother you may say tu kashi asai, or to your auntie you may say tu kashi asai, and for your sister you say tu kashe asai, how are you? Then the answer should be, for all these questions, answer should be Aao Boro Asa. You, if you are a man or a boy, you must say Aao Boro Asa. If you are a woman, listen carefully, and those who know little Konkani among you will tend to make a mistake. Aao Bari Asa, not Aao Bare Asa. You are a lady, you're supposed to say Aao Bari Asa. Ani Aao Bare Asa, also used, but this is supposed to be, this form is preferred. Suppose I ask you to a girl, Tu Kashe Asai, that girl, you go to Aldona, you go to Moira, and certain places in Bardesh. The girl, small girl, she may be 7 years, 8 years old, she will say Aam Bari Asa. Aam Boro Asa, Aam Bari Asa, Aam Bari Asa. But in the colloquial Konkani, a lady of 60, 70, 80 years old, she would say Aam Bari Asa. No, no. In a standard company, it should be Aam Bari Asa. I am fine. Then, a group of people are there, men. Then they would say, Ami Bore Asam. Aam Boro Asa. Ami Bore Asam. And the women, they would say, Ami Borio Asam. And mixed one, men and women or children would say, Ami Bari Asam. We are fine. Then, Tumka Kite Zai. What do you want? But for a boy or girl, you can ask, Tuka Kite Zai. Tumka Kite Zai. Or Tuka Kite Zai. That person might say, Maka Kafi Zai. I want coffee. Maka dash dash melat, can I have dash dash, whatever you want. And I put a number of words here. Suppose you want water, then you say maka udak melat. Now immediately some of you who know little Kondi may say, but we say udak, we say udik, all dialectal. Udak, maka udak melat. Cha, Suppose you want tea, then you must say maka cha malat. Or you want feni, a local drink of a cashew apple or coconut palm. Now practically coconut palm feni is not available in Goa, and what is sold in the shops with a coconut picture on the bottle, all fake. It is meant for tourist consumption. Even this is also fake, most of the shops. Only if you know a well-known shop, and they might give you a real, the genuine one. Otherwise, most of these are all synthetic stuff. Anyhow, you can say maka feni melot. Now you want milk, then you must say maka dood melot. You want buttermilk, then you must say maka taak melot. If you want curd, maka dahi melot. This is not dhani. Maka dahi melot. Then soda. Kongni we say sod. Maka sod melot. Then sarbat. A Persian word has come to Kongni. Drink made of lemon or syrup. Maka sarbat melot. So in this dash, you can put these words and any other words, whatever you want. Maka ambo melot. Whatever you want, you can put here. Before I proceed, any doubts up to now, from Dev Boro, this Dev, up to here? Any doubts, any questions?
Doctor, pore ta te choi ta jay na.
Little louder.
Pore ta.
How pore ta? How pore ta? I will see. Let me see.
Yeah, choi ta hai ode nami.
Kide?
Kide?
Choi ta.
Yes. Pulsate choi ta. Correct. How choi ta?
Choi ta. Correct.
Why there is a echo here? Savio?
There is some problem with the person, that person who was speaking to you right now, no? There is some problem with his device.
I see.
Because we are not able to listen to his voice, but your voice is like echoing more.
Echoing. So it is correct?
Yeah.
Correct.
Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Father, last of the sharbat, most of them say thondi.
Yeah, that means you want a cold drink.
Achha, okay.
The thondi could mean anything. Thondi could be a beer. Okay. It could be a soft drink, Coca-Cola or Fanta, whatever.
Okay.
Thondi.
Father, we can use tan for water. Tan.
Beg pardon?
Tan.
Pan?
Yeah, for water.
What is this?
Pan means thirst.
Pan, we don't use the word water. No.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Father.
Yes.
This word vegi korat.
Vegi.
Father, we pronounce it with a V or with a B?
Ah, good question. That is a, in Konkani, the V sometimes become B. Vegi ye and vegi ye. But I gave you vegi because in a standard Konkani it is vegi. And vegi is in the colloquial one.
Okay, Father.
It is not wrong, mind you. I'm not saying it is wrong.
Okay, Father. Thank you.
When it's a wrong, I say wrong. When I say dialectal, I say colloquial, means that's how people speak. Because any language you take in the world, a language changes from place to place. According to age, the elderly people will speak one way and the younger generation will speak the language another way. According to religion also in India, language changes. According to caste in India, language changes. And in Africa, according to the gender, language changes. Men will speak the same language one way and the women would speak the same language another way. But we don't have that as far as Konkani is concerned. but you are vegi, vegi ye or begi ye. Yes.
Thank you, Father.
Yes.
Excuse me, Father.
Yes.
How are you? I'm fine. That gender thing, can you just repeat one more time, please?
Yes. How are you? Tu kaso? Where it is now? No, not there. Tu kaso asai? Where is it now? Kaso. No, I have not given, I think. Have I given that? Kaso asai. No, I have not.
Huh? Yes, Father. Towards the end it is.
Ah, here. See, tumi kashe asat. Tumi. And tumi kashe asat for women. And for men and women or children, tumi kashe asat. But for a singular person, tu kaso. See, yes, and here it become x, because this I will tell you right now, since you asked me. S followed by vowel a or a, the s becomes sh.
Okay, Father.
See, let me repeat. Let me say in English. S followed by letter I or E, the S changes to X. Here also, see, same way, see, XI. It cannot be SI.
Okay.
This is the rule in Konkani. This is called it is palatalization.
Father?
Yes.
Father, usually when people are talking, informal, when they talk, they use re at the end. Is it?
I will come to that. I will come to that. Don't worry. It is okay. There. I will come to your question. I will tell you there only. It is, you are going to learn today. It's now itself. Anything else? We'll proceed then.
No, we can continue.
Yes. Now here, your question. Whoever asked this question, I have written here. NB.
Hello.
Yes.
Excuse me, Paul.
Yes.
I want to clear something.
Yes.
Vamai Rauta.
Yes.
Rauta Vamai. Which is the way?
Aam Mumbai Rauta. In Konkani, always the verb should come at the end.
Yeah.
In Konkani, Indian languages, verb comes at the end. Grammar structure. Always remember simple. Vowel comes at the end of a sentence in Konkani. Yes.
Because you said, that says Rauta.
Yes.
You cannot say Rauta.
No. You have used all Konkani words. And see, this is the Konkani word written in Roman script. Thanks be to God, Father Vasco da Rego, who revived the Konkani through church. We got a standard Konkani due to Father Vasco Rego, Felix Cardozo, who is no more Konkani writer. So these are the few people, Monsignor Cruz Fernandez, who worked on Bible. So these are the people who revived our language and put Konkani in modern script on a certain platform. I am basing on that, but I'm taking ahead. The writing system, mine is not theirs. So I'm using a writing system user-friendly. Plus, whatever mistakes they did, I'm avoiding. Even the mistake which I did yesterday, I will not repeat today. The moment somebody points out to me, I realize, I remove it immediately. I'm also in the process of learning. Don't think that thing. As a surgeon is in the process of learning, I am also in the process of learning. Now, NB. Do you know what is NB?
Secondly, I want to ask you.
Yes.
The letter Y is pronounced like I.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. If you know Hindi Marathi, if you know Hindi Marathi, the ear, like guy.
Yeah. Not E.
E for us, letter I. For E pronunciation, I. I have used one symbol, one pronunciation.
So it is B-A-N-Y means by, not Bani.
Yes, correct. Yeah. Now, N-B. This is the Latin phrase, nota bene. Take note of, NB. We have many Latin abbreviations we use in English. For example, EG. What is EG? Exempli gratia, for example. Then we use I dot E. And we say in English, that is, it is it est. And we write etc, not etc, 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 the pronunciation. Anyhow, I have not come to teach you English here. That English of Goa, that's another story. If I tell you, either you will laugh or you will get angry with me. Anyhow, now let us go. NB. One, it is strongly advisable to avoid the use of are, re, and ago or go in our speech. It is really an insult to use it for elders. You cannot use for elders. While addressing even to children, it is better to avoid. Example, you simply say two words. Instead of saying to watch re, to watch go. This happens only in Konkani. I can share you any one of my unpleasant experiences. In Maharashtra, if we use re, my goodness, you will get a slap on your face. I had such occasion. Luckily, he didn't beat me, a conductor in the bus. Hindi speakers, you go to Lucknow Hindi, there the father and mother would address their children as aap, not tu, not tum, aap. Such respect. And Konkani, anything will do. I get irritated with this Konkani here in Goa because I don't use anybody are, re. I have deleted this from my, I didn't use it because in my household, we never use this. But by mistake, sometime when I use, my dad corrected me. He said, there is no are and re ago and in our house here. My dad, I was a priest, but my dad corrected me with a stern voice. Usually he never spoke. He was a very soft-spoken person. I used this word for my nephew, my sister's small fellow who was 3 years old. And my dad corrected me. No, he said, don't use it. This is not our culture, he said. And he is right. Now, Hindi, Marathi, all Indian languages don't use this one. So why should we use? In a market, let me tell you, I went to Panji market morning a few years ago, and there was a small boy selling coriander leaves, green leaves, coriander. So he was asking me, Patram, Gere, Patram, Gere. I stopped and told him, you are not speaking correct Konkani. Then he asked me, Patram, did I insult you? Of course, I said, you insulted me. He said, how? Everybody says. Then I told him, because I knew he's a Kannada boy, Kannada speaking. I told him in his own language, you can't speak this way. You say, Patram, Patmir Gata. You can use singular, no problem, at least. But not Patram Gere, you were saying. No. This Konkani I called Rego Konkani, the Goa Catholic Konkani, or Go, I call Rego Konkani. Re and Go for everything. So I prefer any time to speak English rather than Konkani. Though I speak Konkani. with everybody. With Konkani speakers, I speak Konkani. I don't offer mass outside Jesuit houses in any parish or any chapel in English. I already offered only Konkani mass. Only twice out of sheer force or necessity I have to offer. Otherwise, in Goa, I offer mass only in Konkani. But now, at very late in age, I have come to realize, is it worth here in Goa speaking Konkani? When you use this sort of a Konkani, which I call third-rate Konkani. Let us avoid. In every language, there is respect. So you can say two words. Tumi vachat. There is no need to say that. And I use this way, and people are quite taken up. Even children, they are taken up to know. Not even a small boy, I use re, and to a girl, go. But we look at this number two. Aga or ga, used for men, and age and ge, used for women, are respectable terms used for elders. And traditionally, among Konkani speakers, these terms were used for people who are senior to us. For example, aga, kide kartai. Suppose there is a man, then you would speak this way. Aga, kide kartai. What are you doing? Or a woman, you would say, age maushe. She is your mother's sister. Then you would say, age maushe. Kashi asai. Auntie, how are you? But what to tell you, modern generation elders do not like these respectable terms. Once I used this term at a place called Aldone. Konkani we say Aldone, Aldonea. In English it is called Aldona. To a lady, I used the word gay, and she said, Father, I translate for you in English. Do I look like an elderly lady? And this is the experience of my friends who only speak Konkani or prefer to speak Konkani. Even today, a gentleman was telling me, he says, ladies don't like using gay to them. They think it is meant for old people. So better to avoid. Just avoid it. This is what I'm saying in third. Since the above mentioned terms are not at all necessary, they are not necessary. It is best to avoid them altogether instead of inviting the risk of insulting some person by using one of them inappropriately. So it is the habit formation. Habit. It is, we are, people are used for every sentence, they will say re and go. Are anybody, a 10 years old boy will say re to a 8 years old man? No. And from us, those people came from outside Goa, learned wrong type of Konkani. Who are at fault? We are at fault. So let us correct ourselves. I correct people. I tell them clearly, either you speak proper Konkani or you speak with me Marathi, Hindi, Marathi, you can speak. I have no problem. Or English. But don't use this re and go. I tell them straight. I correct them on the spot. Then, fourth one, we have to use respectable words related to death, burial, or cremation. It is not used in Goa, unfortunately. Example, ye, mozo bapui, oh mozo bhav, oh mozo garkar. Look at here, garkar. Go is a very common term. Garkar, opati. O mazo shezari, antarlo, devadin jalo, somplo. And I learned this is in Belgaum villages. Devager gelo. Why it is come twice? Only once it should come. Devager gelo. Beautiful phrase, this one. They don't say none of this in Belgaum village Konkani. They say, mozo bapoi devager gelo, mozo bhav devager gelo. Very nice. My father, brother, husband, neighbor died, passed away, expired in English. From this. But if it's a lady, what are you supposed to say? Maji avoi, wa maji bhain, maji gharkarn, gharkar, gharkarn, pati, patin, not pati. I've written pati here. Don't say pati. Pati means bag. Pati and patin. Or sezarn, sezari, but sezarn, lady. Antarli, here antarlo, here antarli. Devadin zalo, devadin zali. Somplo, sompli, devager geli. This is a way we have to learn to say, not mellow. Bapre, mellow is a dog dies, a cat dies. You can say, kine, maje sune mele, maje mazar mele, maje gai mele, mazo redo mello. No, for human beings, let us use a standard Konkani, as they have done in Hebrew. Use words like antarlo, devadin zalo, somplo, devager gelo, and there's another term used in Karwar and downward, sarlo. Any one of these you can use. But in Goa, or you can say also bhair padlo. There is one word, bhair padlo. I didn't give you, because if you say bhair padlo, it is okay. You go to science stream of that area, they will laugh at you. They will say bhair padlo means for them lost. You have lost something. They will say, search for him then, they will say. You lost it, no? Go and search. Or pidarzalo, some people say. It's from Portuguese, pidar. Pidarzalo means got spoiled. My goodness, mango gets spoiled. A papaya gets spoiled. Daddy got spoiled. Che. No, no, no. So you can use either antarlo, devadinzalo, somplo, devagirgalo, even bhairpadlo, I would say, okay. So I have not given here, even bhair padlo is okay. Oh. Then, next one. See, tacho ticho inter zalo. He, she was interred, buried, laid to rest. Tacho ticho inter zalo, you may say. Or you may say, tachi or tichi kud nike pili. Not Nikipili. In church Konkani, there is a mistake. They put I here. It's wrong. Nikipili or Mati Eklaili. He, she was buried, laid to rest. Let me repeat. Tachi, Tichi, Kud, Nikipili or Mati Eklaili. See. Tachi, Tichi, Melali, Kud. His or her dead body. And Hindus would say, tache, tiche, prat. Of course, it's a Marathi word, and their religious term, they use Marathi word, quite okay. It means his, her dead body. Hindus in Goa use this phrase. Tache, prat, hadle. Tache, prat, vele. Like this they speak. Avoid using expressions like tache, tiche, mode. Takapurlo. Takapurlo. For a dog, you can say. Sunang purlo, mazrak purle, tika purli, no, yana church Konkani, you see, Jesu melo and Jesu purlo, sheh, what a Konkani it is. No, we have to change. This is, say, no, a Konkani has become in Goa of a language of a no class people. It has not been given a respectable platform, and we must give. And who should give? People like us. People who you take part in this online course, if you start speaking and you see the change, we can bring a change in Goa. Let others speak what they the way they like to speak. As Eliezer Ben Yehuda did an attempt, we can make an attempt in Goa. This is only in Goa, mainly. Let me tell you, outside Goa, nobody will speak this way. No. Tache, tiche, made, avoid. Takapurlo, avoid. Say this. Tachi kud nikepili or tachi kud matieklaili, whatever. Then, for Hindu community, when you are speaking to Hindu community, be careful. You must say, tacher or ticher nimane samskar kele Nimane Samskar literally means last rites. But in English, is it has his, her cremation is over? You can speak this way. Tacher Nimane Samskar Kele. And if it is a lady, you can say Ticher Nimane Samskar Kele. Or you may say Taka Agni Dilo or Tika Agni Dilo. Agni means fire. You can say either this or this. Or you may say Taka Velo if it's a man. And if it's a woman, you can say Tika Veli. Have they taken his, her body for cremation? Avoid using expressions like Taka Laslo. No, you will insult them. Tika Lasli or Taka Uzodilo or Tika Uzodilo. No, no, no. It is the same. Cremation means burning. Now you may say, why it is Agni? Why not Uzo? No. You can't use this term. Because they don't use this term and they will feel very hurt. So, while speaking to Hindus, use these phrases, these three. And Catholics, I've given above. Then, the last one is Ganesh festival. Is the most important festival among Marathi and Konkani speakers. And after 1.5 day or 3 days, 5 days, 9 days, 11 days, 21 days, the immersion takes place. Then we must say, if you want to ask the question to your neighbor, Tumi Ganpati Utka Pavailo. Did you immerse the idol of Ganpati? And this is the English translation. Tumi Ganpati Utka Pavailo is the best and respectable way of speaking. Avoid sentences like, I put all bold. Bold means all this you have to avoid. Avoid sentences like, Tumi Ganpati Udailo or Budailo. No, no. The process is same. Here also, you take the idol to the water, and here also same, but you cannot use, you have to give respect for them. Ganpati, with such respect and devotion they do, we cannot use Budailo. So Tumi Ganpati Utka Pavailo, this is the best expression which you can use in the when there is a Ganesh festival. So these are the a few, not this is not an exhaustive list, but important sentences and phrases which we have to learn by heart. Let me tell you, we have to learn all this by heart. Language involves a lot of memory. So when you learn by heart correctly, with correct pronunciation, automatically you will speak correctly. In a language learning process, there are four stages. Listening. How a baby learns a language? Baby listens. And one day, the baby would speak. Listening, then we start speaking. The baby will start, Papa, Mama, Dada, Baba, something like this. Labial sounds. The child speaks. Slowly, slowly. Then comes reading and writing. This is the language learning process. But you being adults, I'm using listening skill, speaking skill, writing. I'm writing. I'm not asking you to write. And reading skill. I'm making you, you have to read. So these three skills we are using for adults. Writing, no, not possible at this stage for you to write, which is takes a lot of effort and time. So any questions on this now, especially from here? Let me take NB. From NB. Because earlier we have asked a question, but before I proceed,
Father, is there a dictionary you would recommend?
Yeah. Now, if you want Roman script, this is not the best dictionary. English Konkani dictionary in Roman script. But in the absence of a best dictionary, you can use it. It is available at Broadway bookstall at Panji near Kakulo Island, and maybe elsewhere, maybe Confidant at Margao, maybe elsewhere. I don't know. But at Broadway bookshop, it is there.
Who are the publishers, Father?
It was written by Isidore Dantas, my friend in he is in Pune, and Joel D'Souza is no more, and it is published by them only. Let me see. No, it is published by Broadway Bookshop, Panjim. That is the biggest bookshop in Goa, as far as I know.
Okay, you must
visit once. So this is the one for Roman script. Then,
Father?
Yes.
How would you say in Konkani, Jesus died and on the third day he rose again?
I will come to you that one. Since they have asked for dictionary, let me complete that. Now, if you know Devanagari script, then there is English Konkani dictionary of Prakash Thali, is no more. He was a teacher at Chogole College, English Konkani. And there is a Konkani English dictionary by Suresh Burkar and Damodar Ghanekar. These are, but in Devanagari script. If you know Devanagari, make use of it. They will help you, because we don't have a full-fledged Roman script dictionary. But if you know Portuguese, Sebastião Rodolfo Delgado, that's outside, this is gone now. What you call the color. So let me show you the first page. This is the reprint. This is Konkani Portuguese dictionary of Monsignor Sebastião Delgado. It's a very good dictionary, very good. You can use this if you know Portuguese. And he has, this is in Devanagari script, mind you, this is in Devanagari script, but he has a Portuguese English dictionary, and sorry, Portuguese Konkani dictionary. Here the Konkani words are given in Roman script. If you know Portuguese, you can use this very good dictionary. Very good. Of course, certain words, modern words are not there. You can't expect, because this was published in 1905 and this one was published in 1883. They are now only reprints. And these are available at a Broadway bookshop. So these are the dictionary. There is one more dictionary, but it is incomplete. So one, let me show you. It is incomplete. This one published by Dalgat Konkani Academy, only volume 1. Volume 2 and volume 3 they have not published, because the man who did the work has not given them the material, I think. So it's only from letter A to F, English, and all the equivalent words are in Roman script. Only these are available. But don't
Father, worry. Sorry, can you repeat worry. The Devanagari authors?
Beg pardon?
Can you repeat the author? You had mentioned Prakash Thali for Devanagari and one
Devanagari. And Devanagari is, you go to Broadway bookshop, you will get them. Prakash Thali. Prakash Thali.
And the other one?
Other one, that Suresh Burkar. But both are published by Broadway, by Rajans Vitaran. This is published by Rajans Vitaran, which is next to Broadway bookshop. If you don't get at Broadway, ask them where is Rajans Vitaran in the next building, Kakulo Island, Panji. You go to the, I think, first floor or second floor, I don't remember exactly now. I think first floor, and you get these dictionaries. And if you really, really you know Konkani and you like, then there is Konkani dictionary by Rajhans. Such a huge one. But Devanagari, of course. This is not available in any bookshop. No, you have to go to Rajhans. Personally, you have to go. And they insist you show them one ID, either your Aadhaar card or something. Usually they ask for an Aadhaar card. And then only they give you, because there is some concessional rate they give for individuals. And for institutions, it is very expensive. So to make sure they record it so that you will not buy second time, only one copy will be sold to you in your name. Okay, now this is about dictionaries. That's all. But person like me, I use, for me, this is like Konkani Bible for me. I mean, for Konkani language, I use the dictionaries. These are three dictionaries put together. Konkani, Portuguese, English of Dr. Rocky Miranda, and compiled by my student who is in Japan, who is senior to me, Professor Toru Maruyama, whom I am still teaching Konkani. He knows old Konkani so well. These are the one I use it for me. So these are, they are here on my table all the time. Okay. That is for so much for dictionary. But don't worry, if it is the God's will, by at least 2022, this coursework will come, and there will be a lot of common words will be there. Konkani English, English Konkani. Basic terms of Konkani, I will make sure they will be there. So that will sufficient for your purpose, but that is not sufficient for at an intermediate and advanced level. No, but for a basic level, surely that will be sufficient for you if you get my book. Okay, now there was a gentleman, he had a question. Bab kide prashn kide, what is your question?
Father, Jesus died and on the third day he rose again. How would you say the same in Konkani?
I can't hear you.
Jesus died and on the third day he rose again. How would you say that in Konkani?
Who? Jesus died
and rose again on the third day.
Why? Jesus. You can say Devadin Zalo Anitisra Disa Jivan Zalo. Or Jesus Somplo Anitisra Disa Jivan Zalo. Not mellow. My goodness. Oh, Jesus Maran Paolo, you say. Maran Paolo, because we use the word Maran. Eightfold. From that Maran, we say now Morn. As usual. Morn word has come. We give the, so use, we have to use a respectable term. Then, which in every language it does. You take any Indian language. Masculine, feminine. They do. That reminds me what we have done. In Konkani, there is a very respectable term, Mam. Mam means maternal uncle. And when we call him, we say Mama, means oh uncle. Maternal uncle is Mam. And while addressing him, we say Mama. And Mama's wife is Mami. They are very respectable terms. But in Goa, this word Mama and Mami are used not for maternal uncle and aunt. They are used for laborers, those who work in your garden, those who work near the roadside. For them, our people say, oh Mama, hey Mami. See what level we have come. We have thrown away our gold and we have brought in, what shall I say, maybe aluminium stuff, and we are using it.
Who is called Irmão? Irmão.
Irmão, Portuguese word for brother.
Okay.
Irmão and Mana. It is used in Belgaum Konkani. In Belgaum people, whom they call themselves as Bardeskars. They were from Goa. For information, Konkani speakers migrated from north and south up to Kerala and here up to Maharashtra. For various reasons. Let's not get into that. So, in Belgaum, Konkani, they would say, Irma, for brother. They will not simply say by his name. No, Irma and Mana to an elder sister. They say Mana, Portuguese words, and they are maintained still. Very nice. In Go also, these words were there, but day by day, all this has gone. All these are gone. Our words, Mama, Mommy, we have become all uncle and aunties now. Anybody is uncle for us, and anybody is an auntie. I will teach you a few, time available, a few kinship term. How to say, what words do we use? I will teach you.
Father, can you repeat the sentence in Konkani? We have to use respectable words related to death, burial, or cremation. Mozo bap.
Yes. I mean, this file you will get tomorrow. Surely you will get tomorrow from Savio, but let me this thing. Please, please, yes. This one.
Number four.
See. I cannot say if my father is died, I cannot say mozo bapoi melo, mozo bapoi pidarzalo. No. Mozo bapoi or bhav, or if a lady would say garkar, a lady would say pati, mozo pati, or mozo sezari, my neighbor, but he should be a man, sezari. Not a woman. Antarlo.
Antarlo means dead.
It is used in Goa, in written Konkani, it is used in Goa, mind you. In Gulab and all, this is used now. After I bring it to the notary, we have to change. They have used, they are using this. These are not from my head. Antarlo. Devadin zalo. Devadin means that Dev, and Adin means surrender to God. What a beautiful term. Devadin zalo. Somplo means finished. Okay. Devagir gelo, a best phrase. Devagir gelo or Devadin zalo, best phrase. But I have used
gone to God.
Huh?
It means gone to God.
Yes, gone to God, correct. Gone back to God. From there we came. No, from where did we come? We came from yes. God, and we are going to return to God. That is our belief in a Christianity. Devagir gelo.
Devagir gelo. Devadin zalo.
Yeah. Father. This is the one.
Thank you. Thank you, Father.
Yeah. Father. Yes. Yes.
My cousin, like when her father died, she said, Amka daddy sodun gelo. That is correct?
Yes, you can say also, sodun gelo, yes. Mozo bapoi, Amka sodun gelo, you can say. Yes.
Father, there's one question here.
Yes. Little louder, Mozo, because here is heavy rain here.
Yeah, yeah. Mozo and Moji, yes. The spellings. Mozo doesn't
have an H. Sorry. Ah, you are right. Here I should remove this.
Okay.
Moji.
That was raised by Araujo.
Let me check. Here it is correct. Here I made it. Correct. This I corrected that day. That gentleman helped me and I corrected myself because this is not found in old Konkani.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Any other doubts? Others, I'm going to proceed.
Father, you yes. have mentioned the example of laborer.
Yeah.
If we have to address laborers with respect, what is the best way to do it?
You can. See, I have no difficulty you expressing, Mama, I have no difficulty, it's a respect. But our people use, instead of, he's an illiterate man, if they're using only for illiterate man as Mama and Mommy, they will not say to a well-dressed person who comes, an engineer, he may be from outside Goa, our fellows, will they say Mama? No, they will say Uncle maybe, or maybe Sir.
But, in Pune, yes. In the hospitals, those ward boys are known as mamas. In Pune hospitals, ward boys are known as mamas. and the female employees are known as Maushi.
Maushi.
In
Pune. Yeah, out of respect you give, I have no problem. I have no problem. Then use it for your own people. No, why not using for your own people? For my maternal uncle, I can say, Oh, Mosa Mom. And I can say, Imoji Maushi. Of course, in Salset, they say, Mashen. No problem. Quite okay. No? So use the terms which you are using for others for your own people first.
Understood.
Yeah. Now, if there are no questions, I will proceed. Savya, I will proceed.
Father?
Yes.
Hello.
There is some question.
Yes.
Be louder, please.
Yeah, Father, why do you say so mellow? Is it right?
Yes, in English you can say died. See, we are not English speakers. English, they may say died or passed away or expired and all. But in Konkani, mellow, you say for dog also mellow. And Mazar Mele and Munisi Mele. There should be some gradation of language, you know. The language of kitchen, the language of a marketplace, we cannot use as a formal. What did I tell you? I am teaching you a formal language and not a colloquial language.
Okay. Thank you, Father.
There is such a known as a colloquial English. Colloquial English in Miramar, the our college girls with all the lipstick. As the bus come, what did they say? Bashir chadgo, Bashir chadgo. Kokani is okay, Bashir chadgo. But they say, what do they say? They say, climb man, climb man, climb man. English speaking girls, they say climb man. Translation of English, Kokani. In English, you don't say climb in, we say get in. Same way. In Konkani, I am teaching you a standard, a formal Konkani, which people will respect you tomorrow, as they are respecting me. Wherever I go, I use this language, and they respect me. If you are a teacher, if you are a person in authority, you are expected to speak a standard language. Okay, at home with your friends. With your family members, you may speak one way. That is your concern. But for me, there is only one language that exists. I don't speak my dialect. I speak what this standard one, which is my dream. And now it is spreading. It is taken up in Goa by many people and elsewhere. Like Devadin Zalo, there is a magazine called Gulab. They use the word Devadin Zalo, Antarlo. All these phrases are there. Yeah. Further, any questions?
Yeah, Father.
Yes.
Do we say chow pielin?
A little louder, please. Because of the rain, yeah. I can't hear here.
Yeah, can we say chow or chai? Chow pielin ki chai.
Okay. There are two, actually cha, and also the Catholic would say chow, C-H-A-V, chow. Tu cha piye or tu chow piye, both are correct.
Okay.
But ti chow.
Ti chow, okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Cha or chow, both are correct. Because they are borrowed words for us. Cha is a borrowed word for us. It's only when the British came to India, we began to learn drinking tea. It is chaha. The chaha became for us cha. And in Konkani written in Roman script, became chow.
Chow.
Okay. Yeah.
But it's correct.
There is also the cha.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes. I think if there are no doubts, Savio, is just 5 minutes left. I think it's not worth starting a new topic.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not worth, but I will continue. If there are questions, I will continue. Even if there is one person is wants to clear the doubt, I have no difficulty. But I will not start a new topic today. Tomorrow we will start. Though I am ready, I have no difficulty.
No, we are just having 5 minutes further. Let's not start a new topic today.
I want to know from my the participants, what I'm speaking, is it audible?
Yes, it is audible.
Yes, very much audible.
Okay. Is my speed, do you find my speed is too fast? Have I to slow down? Have I to still speak, especially Konkani, slowly?
No, I think it's fine.
I think it's fine.
I'm repeating, because repetition is very important. Because here there are different types of people, the newcomers who do not know Konkani at all. Yeah. I have a request. I've been told there are two participants from UK. And any one of my English sentences here, if they are not correct, please correct me. I am trying to use British English and not the American. See your neighbor, I use the British spelling. And as far as possible, I try to use British construction. See, my first language is not English. Nobody spoke English at home. I did not study till 10th standard in English medium. For me, English is a third language. It is a broken English, I say. My English is broken, I admit. But people here speak still worse than my English. So I want the help from those two participants. For English is concerned, anything which I give in square brackets, if there are any mistakes, not spelling mistakes, of course, others can correct me. Better expressions, please let me know.
Father?
Yes?
Father?
Yes?
Usually we do not use the word expired for a human being, no, Father?
Yeah, I mean, I checked that one. Now, those are British. Two participants can correct me. I checked in the dictionary of this one. They give that expired. They give in the synonym dictionary. Usually it is for objects. I know. That way, passed away is also. You can say what? The storm passed away, you can say. But we say also, he passed away. My dad passed away. So if I'm wrong, those from UK can correct me.
Because my father, when I was doing B.Ed, my English teacher had corrected me saying never use the word expired for human being.
I see. Who corrected you?
Sharmila Veloso.
Said, okay, she is an English teacher. So I this one, still let me check now this one. If it is not one, you see, I have no, what you call, argument because regarding English, because my first language is not English.
Expired is given.
So if we think this should not be, we'll remove it. What is the difficulty? I have no difficulty at all.
No, not there, Father, but I'm saying like people are normally using it in newspapers on the obituary page,
yes.
You know.
So I'll remove it here, Pastor, because what is important is you understand what I'm saying. I'm not here to teach you English. So what is important is this Konkani sentence, how to say in English. So this is enough. Neighbor died or passed away is enough. No.
Yes.
I have no difficulty. If Sharmila Veloso said she was my teacher, she was my teacher for B.Ed., I accept. Because she speaks good English.
Yes, Father.
Because she studied in Mumbai.
Yes, yes, Father.
Therefore, who corrects is very important.
It is already 8 o'clock, Father.
Yeah. So, Dev Varen Karu.
Tum Kaya Karun.
And Dev Vari Rat Dev.
Tum
Kaya Dev.
Tum Kaya Dev. Mogasu. Tum
Kaya Dev.
Mogasu.
What
is that? I said Mogasu.
What should be
with love?